Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of Hyperbolas. We're working with hyperbola centered at the origin, and we graph these two hyperbolas, and then we do this other problem at the bottom. We'll be graphing more hyperbolas in this video that are centered at the origin, and we have these two forms of a hyperbola depending on if it opens left and right or up and down. And we've got either x-intercepts if it's in the first form or y-intercepts if it's in the second form, and the asymptotes in both cases will be y plus or minus b over ax. So here's our first problem. Graph x squared over 25 minus y squared over 4 equals 1. Now, notice I didn't put it in the form over a squared or over b squared, but you can rewrite that if you'd like as x squared over 5 squared minus y squared over 2 squared equals 1. You don't have to write it, but you do have to recognize that a is 5 and b is 2. A is the one that corresponds with the x, and b corresponds with a y. So since I've got basically an x squared minus y squared problem, that means we've got x-intercepts. So the intercepts will be x-intercepts, and so we will have 5, 5, 0, and negative 5, 0. Or you could just put plus or minus 5 if you write x-intercepts. So we know those are points on the graph. Now, what about the asymptotes? Those are lines. So the asymptotes is the line y equals mx, and m is always y over x. So in this case, it'll be 2 over 5 plus or minus. I started to write the 5 at the top. 2/5. X. So remember that's two different lines. One is y equals 2/5, one equals is negative 2/5 x in both cases. And we could draw the little rectangle. A lot of people like that. That's up to you. You don't have to draw the rectangle, but you do have to draw the asymptotes. This just helps you draw the asymptotes because they just go through the corners. So here's our asymptotes. It goes through the origin. And those are guidelines, okay? That's how you could think of it. So this is going to open to the right and left because there's x-intercepts, so we just do something like that. Something like that, and that's it. So basically what the asymptotes is guide you, like is it a little skinny thing like this, or is it kind of like this? You know, you're going to get all sorts of different possibilities based on the values of a and b, and that's what the asymptotes do for you. They will guide you. Remember, the other way to do this is to plug in a bunch of values of x, solve for y, and plot lots and lots of ordered pairs. That's the hard way to do it. All right, here's our next problem. By the way, feel free to put the video on pause and try it on your own first. The first thing you want to notice, this is not in the standard form for a hyperbola, right? Because we don't have it equaling to 1. So that's the first thing you notice. We need to make sure that it's equal to 1. And the reason we know this is a hyperbola and not an ellipse is because of the minus sign here, right? If it was a plus, it would be the form of an ellipse that isn't quite in standard form yet. So our first thing to do will be to divide everything by 144. So that we're going to have it equal to 1. And it's kind of convenient here. I gave you a problem where 9 times 16 was 144. So when I cancel here, you end up getting 16 in the denominator here. We end up getting 9 in the denominator here. So I could write this as y squared over 16 or y squared over 4 squared minus x squared over 9, which I could write as 3 squared, equals 1. So notice, instead of writing 16 and 9, I'm writing them so you could see the values of A, in this case, is 3 and B is 4. All right, this is the second form of a hyperbola, right? I've got the minus sign in front of the x squared this time and the plus sign in front of the y squared, so there will be y-intercepts. So the y-intercepts are at plus or minus 4. You could write those as ordered pairs, or you could write plus or minus 4. So the y-intercepts are at plus or minus 4. That means it goes through the y-axis this time, plus or minus 4. So this hyperbola is going to open upward and downward. And then we're going to do a little box. I know there is really no x-intercept, but that just helps us make this little rectangle right here. Again, you don't need to draw the rectangle. You can go ahead and just draw the asymptotes, which are y equals plus or minus, and that what we took the value under the y over the value under the x. Remember, think of slope as being y over x, 4/3 x. So that's two equations, y equals 4/3 x. If we were to graph y equals 4/3 x, remember that just means that's the slope, and 0 is the y-intercept. So you can get that line by saying, oh, here's the y-intercept. We're going to go over 3 and up 4 and have this other point, and of course you're going to draw right through that. But the box is just a quick and easy way to do that. So we draw the asymptotes. And if you're asked to label them, then of course go ahead and label them. Like for instance, this is the one y equals negative 4/3 x because it slants in the negative direction, right? And the slope's in the negative direction. And this one's positive, so you could write that this one up here is y equals positive 4/3 x. Okay, if you were asked to label that. And we just are going to use these asymptotes as guidelines to sketch the hyperbola. Okay, now remember, I wasn't doing this on the other ones. It really goes forever, so I'm going to put little arrows on it, just like a line is supposed to have arrows on it. And so that's the hyperbola. It really goes forever and ever, both up and down. So we started out with 9y squared minus 16x squared equals 144. We put it in standard form, and then we figured out the intercepts and the asymptotes, drew the box, drew the asymptotes, and then from there you just, you know, it goes through the intercept and you use your asymptotes as guidelines. Right, here's a problem where we're given an equation that at first glance looks like it's in standard form, but it's not. And we're not going to graph it. What we're going to do is put it in standard form, state the intercepts, state whether it goes up or down, or right and left, and then state the equations of the asymptotes. All right, so let's go for it. Why is this not in standard form? Think about that. It's equal to 1, so that part is all good. But there's another problem. Hopefully you see it. The problem is it should just have an x squared or a y squared in the numerator. So I have to deal with this 25 that's in the x squared term. The way to deal with that is if I multiply the numerator by 1/25, right, the reciprocal, I'll get 1. But if I multiply the numerator, I also have to multiply the denominator by that. So I'm really multiplying top and bottom of this fraction by 1/25 over 1/25. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing for this other one. I'm going to leave my minus sign over here to give me a little space. So how do I get rid of this 4 in the numerator? I multiply by its reciprocal, so I multiply the numerator and denominator by 1/4 for the second fraction. So the first fraction now is x squared over, well, it's a fraction of the denominator, but that's okay, 16/25. That's the whole denominator minus. In the numerator of this next fraction, we'll only have the y squared, and we'll have a 9/4. And it's still equal to 1. Do you need those parentheses? No. I just did it so you could think of that as the whole denominator. Now, that could be thought of as standard form, or what you could do is write that as 4/5 squared. 16/25 is 4/5 squared minus. How could I write 9/4 as something squared? That would be 3/2 equals 1. So this, either of these, could be considered standard form. Right, what else does it ask? So we wrote the equation in standard form. Second, state the intercepts. Okay, so how are we going to get the intercepts? Well, in front of the x squared, it's positive when it was equal to 1. So we know that there are x-intercepts, not y-intercepts. So what are the x-intercepts? So the x-intercepts will be what? 4/5 0 and negative 4/5 0. And by the way, there's no y-intercepts, right? Just keep remember that. Right, what else are we asked? State if it opens up or down. Okay, if there's x-intercepts, which way is it going to open? It's going to open left and right. So you know, like it's going to go something like that. I don't know exactly how wide these are going to look, if they're going to look skinny or whatever, or fat, but it is going to open left or right because, like, there's going to be these intercepts on the x-axis. And these intercepts right here are actually called the vertices of the hyperbola. There's one on the left, the one that opens to the left, and there's one on the one that opens to the right. Then it asks to state the equations of the asymptotes. All right, so that's our last step. How do you get the equations of the asymptotes? Remember, it's y equals plus or minus a over b. I'm sorry, b over a. You take the number under the y, which is 3/2, divided by the number under the x, which is 4/5 x. Remember, it's an equation of a line, and that's the slope. Now, we could simplify that slope. That's a complex fraction. We don't want to leave it like that. So 3/5, this means, I'm sorry, 3/2 divided by 4/5 is the same thing as 3/2 times 5/4. So that'll give me 15/8. So that's a little bit neater way of writing the asymptotes, which you definitely want to do. So that'll be 15/8 x. Some people know the little trick. You could multiply if you have one fraction over another fraction. If you multiply the very top and very bottom number, that's your new numerator. And you multiply the ones on the in the middle, that's your new denominator. So if you know that little trick, you could do that, but hopefully you understand why that's true in any case. So we've got our equations of the asymptotes. We've got that it opens left and right, and we have our intercepts, which only happens to be x and y intercepts, and we're done. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.